Welcome back, folks. This is Joe Whittle, and this is Heavy Rain. And this is a disturbing image of a little boy who looks a little derpy. Phew. Last time we nearly escaped. The plans of Scott. Oh man, who would have ever thought that he was gonna be the origami killer? I couldn't have thunk it. Especially, like, I don't know. So cray cray. Okay. I wonder if the origami killer can change depending on your playthrough. No. That would be crazy. I'm gonna have to look some of this stuff up later. Jason! Yeah, he's right there. Keep going. Wow, he looks rough. Any food? I guess he's, as I would say, has he had any water? But I guess he's had, he's got plenty of water, right? We need to beat the hell out of this lock, I guess. Something that looks like something to me. Yeah, it looks big enough for bashing. Come on, pry that son of a bitch off. Aw, damn it. Stick it in there again. An old piece of shit lock. Good job. Son of a bitch is heavy. Oh, I got good Metal Gear Solid practice. Ugh. Oh god. Hell out of there. Oh, you're all water weight. Ooh, he looks like a fish.
My god. Sean, answer me. Breathe. Gotta breathe.
He was just alive and breathing like 2 seconds ago. Am I being led to believe that I was like 10 seconds late? Don't mess this up.
Don't leave me. Sean.
Are you shitting me? I was too fucking late. Drell, I did. Roll him over. Pound his chest. Try a little harder. Yeah, see? Try to shake him, roll him over. Have you seen the movies?
Sean. Oh. Oh. I thought you were gone.
You're trying to do smother him?
Come and save me.
That's right, I'm here now. I'm gonna get out of there though.
Sean, listen. You are the best thing that's ever happened to me in my life. Know that whatever happens, I love you more than anything in the world. I'm not dead. I took the poison an hour ago. And I'm not dead.
So what's gonna happen with...
What are you doing?
Alright.
I did some hunting around. I know who the killer is, Ethan. I can prove your innocence.
Congratulations, Ethan. You succeeded. You're the father that I have been looking for all these years. The man capable of giving his own life to save his son.
You got what you wanted. I finished your trials. Now let us go.
I'm afraid that's not possible. Your lady friend knows my little secret. I don't intend to end my days in prison. I'm going to have to kill you. I'm sorry. You earned my respect.
What? I fucked up the QuickTime event? Are you shitting me? Fucking Ethan is dead because of my slow hands! God damn it! Why would you pick a ladder to climb up? You left that kid. Oh my god. What the fuck? How did he get up there so quick? What is going on? How are we on this scaffolding all of a sudden? My god. Madison. Hey, it's like that old game they used to play when they were kids. Except they didn't break their leg on stuff. Oh my god. Broken legs everywhere. Jesus Christ, it just looks painful to watch. Oh, we're like down at the docks here. Shinmu, man, get the old forklift out. Move some cargo. Go right. He's gonna circle around us. Oh, his gun jammed. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, this is a really difficult button smash. Asher here. There we go. Fuck this guy. Yeah. Take that. Take that. Oh, God. Oh. What the hell? What the? Get down! Oh my God. Oh. Oh my God. No, left, right. Give me some leeway, man! Cut me a fucking slack, dude! Jesus fucking Christ. Fuck you. Fuck you. Ethan, my boy. Yeah, put another one in him. Now, I did not, in my wildest dreams, think that this was going to end at that, the top of some crane, in some kind of crazy slasher film type ending. What in the world? Just next thing you know, Scott just turned into a fucking madman. When he ripped her out of that window and threw her over the rail, Jesus Christ, he had like Hulk-like strength.
There was general relief this morning when the police announced that they had found Sean Mars.
Yeah, I've got some general relief.
After his disappearance, Mars had been imprisoned in a well.
What the fuck? But now look at these guys. Why does the... Is this like supposed to be some kind of...
This case was made possible only by the bravery of Ethan Mars, who the police believed at one point to be the killer. It is no doubt due to his great...
Why does this newscast look so fake? Like, these graphics look fake. Is that some kind of statement to say that the news and, like, TV is fake?
Apology today.
Unreal.
It is reported that the police have identified the man thought to be the origami killer. Scott Shelby, 48, is a former police lieutenant who claimed to be a private eye hired by the families of the killer's victims. Shelby was killed during a massive police operation, but further details have not yet been released to the public.
Wow. Scott Shelby. Jesus.
Let's just say a friend let me jump in line. If we like it, it's ours.
My God, I got a half decent fucking ending here. Ethan gets his life back together. Sean Mars lives.
Hey, Dad.
Madison lives.
Well, what do you think?
Perfect, Ethan. We'll be able to forget what happened. We'll lead a normal life.
No, we won't.
And one day, it'll all just seem like a bad dream. We've earned the right to be happy now, Ethan. All three of us.
Hey, you little bastard, get back here. Oh. Man, good job. Good job, me. I'm gonna go ahead and take the credit for this one. It's these fast thumbs. Are we going to talk about Jaden being dead?
He's being buried in 2 days in some godforsaken hole in the back end of beyond near Washington. I have to attend as a matter of protocol.
I'll pass. Jaden and I didn't see eye to eye on much.
No problem. I understand.
Yeah.
Hey, sir, Jaden. I still have his glasses. What should I do with them?
Well, we'll be needing them again. Do whatever you want with them.
Cool. It's like interactive ESPN on here, man.
Put them on, you know you want to.
Put them on. Where? Me. Check out my UV protection. I love the Airy system. It's so bad.
What the fuck? Oh, man. That would be so cool if I could just put on a pair glasses like that at work, and I could just be there. I'd never want to leave. That would actually would be like the future, man. Just someone, but just bother you. Just take them off and like deal with your shit. Put your glasses back on, next thing you know, you're at the Grand Canyon or something. Okay. Oh my god. Jaden is a fucking ghost now. Dude, please tell me there's gonna be a heavy rain 2 where Jaden is killing everybody from the grave. Wow, this lady's probably super depressed. Scott Shelby killed her son. She fell in love with them.
Were you thinking about that when you held me in your arms? I don't know why you did all this.
I don't think anybody does. Besides some weird
nothing
plot in a video
justify
game.
It anyway.
Sales?
Nothing
that tombstone didn't do anything to you. and Scott Shelby's ghost will be duking it out in the sequel. I'll be back!
I want to see them again.
I'm a father too.
Right. David Cage. All right, well, I guess we got time here, so let's get into it. Yeah, I mean, good game, ambitious. If this game is anything, or should be accused of anything, it's probably being a little bit over ambitious in the fact that I don't know, it's the storytelling was good, but it just, the story itself seemed forced, you know? There seemed like there was just a lot of unnecessary things, you know? Like, I get all the trials he had to go through, but Shelby's turn or twist to being the killer was just so dramatic. This game could have been directed by M. Night Shyamalan, and I would have never known the difference. I mean, the entire time, who did I say my favorite character was multiple times? Of course it turns out to be the fucking killer. Although I did like Madison too, that's just because she's a fox. And besides that, she was the only one that actually didn't seem crazy. And turns out, I guess she wasn't, so good. That would have been stupid if she, like she was or something. So, what's the deal with, like, Shelby? He goes to investigate, like, this guy's son right here, you know? Why would he even do that on his own free time? Oh, I guess he did take what's her name with him. I don't know. The graphics were great. I can't even believe, you know, how good they were for the PS3. I mean, this looks like something that would have been on the PS4. Really, I can only imagine if they would have worked on a game, or I'm sure they probably are working on a game. I think I heard that there's supposed to be a PS4 port for this game pretty soon, like a remake. So I don't know. What can I say? I'm happy I played it. Happy I beat it. Another successful Let's Play. Not what I anticipated. Well, I don't know, is it? I wanted it to be a mystery. I wanted it to have some action sequences. It had sex, violence, mystery, some deaths. I got to make some moral choices, solve some puzzles. Wait a minute. This is actually adding up like something good. Huh. So why did I not enjoy this? I think for all intents and purposes, I did enjoy the game. Probably the fact that I was recording it is the biggest thing. I mean, it's nerve-wracking when you have to get these quick time events down, and some of these sequences down quickly, and if you don't, then you know good luck. And you're trying to do that, you're trying to talk, you're trying to pay attention. So, and that's not the first time that that's happened in one of my Let's Plays. I kind of let that disrupt some of my early parts of Metroid Prime, so I think that's just comes with the territory. So I'm not gonna give this game a rating or anything, but I would say if you got a PS3 laying around, you can pick this up for like $10. So if you're interested to go down some of all those other choice paths and unravel some more of the clues to see what could have been, then that's just probably worth it. I can't say I'm gonna play it right away or anything, but this would be an interesting game to like maybe play with Katie or someone else and just kind of go through and see what kind of decisions they would make. So I'll keep that in mind, you know, maybe we'll do that one day. It is kind of a dark, slightly gory game, but I think she'd be alright with it. And overall, wasn't too much gore, I don't suppose. getting some freezing here. I'm not sure what's up with that. Kind of want to let the credits roll out just to see if there's anything at the end. You never know. Is it like a movie where the credits roll and then there's like a 10-second clip? I hate it when that happens. So I'm always leaving the theater. You know, I ain't got time for that. Speaking of which, this is totally unrelated note, but the Star Wars full trailer released tonight, so I'm about to actually go YouTube that before I go to bed, see if that's been posted yet. They did it during Monday Night Football. Monday Night Foosball. So I'm really excited about that. I'm getting pumped up for it. Regardless of this J.J. Abrams nonsense, I'm just going into it with good hopes. Yeah, it's my video. Is freezing. I'm not sure why. Yeah, I don't know. Everything I was adding up just a few minutes ago there sounded like all the ingredients for a delicious game, so. I think just the fact that I was let's playing this is the only thing that held it back for me from achieving, you know, ultimate satisfaction through the playthrough. And like, yeah, I mean, that's definitely not its fault, it's just the consequence of trying to do a recording of it. And that's, I guess, why I like to stick to some of the more, just platformers. Stuff that doesn't have a lot of dialogue or, like, cutscenes, and I can just kind of ramble and talk like I'm doing now. And, you know, just play platform, whatever. Not have to not have to deal with characters interacting so often, and I can't say it enough, and I'm kind of sick of saying it. I'm kind of blue in the face here, but the whole QuickTime event stuff has to stop. The next game I play, I swear to God, if it has QuickTime events, I don't even know. I'm gonna do research just to make sure it doesn't. I mean, they have their place, I feel like. I think I might even given this example once during the game, but like, I can't remember what game it was I was playing. Maybe it was a Gears of War? during your reload, you had to get the button combination right, the quick time event on the reload, and if you did, you got the fast reload, and if you didn't, you're clip jammed or whatever, and it was like a slow reload. That's the perfect implementation of it. Stuff like that. But, things in this game, the whole motion stuff was pretty interesting. Okay, yeah. No, that's it. So, anyway. Yeah, good game. Check it out if you can. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.